Dozens of college fraternity brothers expect to be charged as early as this morning for the death which happened during a wild frat weekend in the Poconos. ABC's Lindsay Davis is tracking the case. Good morning, Lindsay.
Good morning, George. And those charges include homicide. They've been expected since May, but authorities were waiting for a medical report and a digital animation of just how this 19-year-old freshman died during a fraternity hazing ritual.
This morning, some 30 college students could face a slew of criminal charges ranging from hazing to possible homicide as a result of the death of this young fraternity pledge, 19-year-old Chun Michael Dang. The Dang family's attorney claims police assure him those charges are imminent.
They have ruled that it is a homicide and that now the only thing left is for charges to be filed.
Authorities say members of the Pi Delta Psi fraternity at New York City's Baruch College pushed the freshman during a hazing ritual where he was blindfolded and wearing a backpack filled with 20 pounds of sand. He later died after suffering blunt force head trauma.
I can say that it involved physical contact, which became very aggressive.
The incident happened in December during a retreat in the Poconos held by the Asian American Cultural Fraternity. Police say after realizing Dang was unconscious, the students did not call 911, but instead waited about 2 hours before driving him to a hospital 45 minutes away. Dang died there the following day.
There shouldn't have been any delay, and yet there was, and then afterwards, there was a cover-up.
Reportedly, investigators say several frat members tried to hide their cell phones from police officers to keep them from seeing videos, photos, and conversations about the hazing rituals. The fraternity now has a lifetime ban at Baruch.
If the coroner determines that delay in seeking treatment resulted in the death of this kid, then that's going to be particularly problematic for all of those who were present.
The Dang family attorney says it is very likely there will be a civil suit as well. At Baruch, the disciplinary process is said to still be underway. George, the district attorney's office is reportedly not commenting.
At least not yet. Okay, Lindsay, thanks. Let's bring in our chief legal affairs anchor, Dan Abrams, with more on this. And Dan, it's got to be a challenge for prosecutors to make a collective prosecution like this really stick.
Yeah, we were expecting an announcement in May about charges. And I think what they've been doing is they have been going through and trying to figure out what each and every individual there did. They've got videos. They may be creating an animation to assess exactly what happened and recreate it. And I think they've been taking their time because there may be very different charges. For one person, let's say, might get a misdemeanor hazing charge, while someone else might be charged with manslaughter. So this is a complicated process. The prosecutor's taking their time. But I think that anyone who was there will likely get charged with something.
And potentially a complicated defense as well, because at some point, these different students who have different kinds of charges could start turning against each other.
Oh, absolutely. And that's why the video becomes so important, right? Because if there was no video, people could say, well, wait a sec, I didn't do it, he did it. Except in this case, there was a lot of cell phone video, which some of them allegedly tried to hide when the authorities started the investigation. And as a result, it's going to be hard for someone who's on video to say, I didn't do that. The question's going to be for those who maybe weren't exactly on the video, maybe some who weren't even there, were they involved in the cover-up? So this is a complicated investigation, and I think prosecutors have been very smart to take their time. But now we expect some charges to be announced.
Okay, Dan Abrams, thanks very much. Okay.